Hello everyone, welcome to Trupti's Craft. Sorry, today I am late. My laptop was acting a little bit weird, so I got late. So how are you doing today? I hope you are getting ready for holidays. I hope you are done with all shopping. I'm done with my shopping. Now I have to just gift wrap all the gifts. So let's start. What I did last week? Last week, you may remember that I showed you one butterfly that I am going to make it. It was in 12 by 12 frame. So I finished that butterfly. But I cannot show you right now because it's a surprise gift. Once that gift is, I think it's for tomorrow. I think they are going to give that gift tomorrow. Then maybe in a couple of days, I will show you the picture of that frame. And then I also did a lot of ornaments and one more cross frame. And yes, I did one more frame. So this is a new one. It was a custom order, so monogram R with Clemson University colors. So this will be the gift for Clemson family. The name family name starts with R. So this is 5x7 frame. So today I did this, and then I have to do two more frames. Those are 8x10. Those will be the names. One is girl's and one is boy's name. So for girl's name, I am going to add some flowers and cats. And for boy's name, he loves video game. So I am going to add some Xbox remotes with his name. So let's see how it goes. This last weekend, I did one craft show. It was good. So this weekend also on Saturday, I'm going to do one last in-person craft show. So let's see how it goes. And this time they are doing one, what, iceless skating ring. So I hope a lot of people will come and they will enjoy the show. If you are living nearby me, so that show will be in Tyson area. So I'm going to put the link there. So if you're living nearby, you can come and join that show. So what we are going to make today? So today also I'm going to show one more ornament because it's Christmas season, right? We need ornaments. And this will be a little bit different. I don't know. I just came up with the idea, the design of that ornament. So let's get started. Let me add my another camera. Okay, I think I'm going to use this mode. Or yeah. And I'm going to change this here, and I'm going to try it, see I can do it. yeah that's the perfect one. So for that I told you, right, that I made a butterfly, 12 by 12 butterfly. So for that one, I ordered these paper strips from quilling.com. So actual color of this paper strip is ivory, but on one side, it is gold, golden edges. You can see. So this is one side is ivory and one side is gold edges. So I wanted to use that. I wanted to make that butterfly gold in gold color. So I ordered these strips. So I thought today let's make some ornaments with these strips. The length of this strips is 24 inches. I'm not going to use full length strips. I'm going to use maybe half strip or 1/4 strip. But if you are using regular strips, that's fine too. So let's take, I want to show you one new tool I have. So it's a battery operated slotted tool. I got it from India. My husband went to India last month, so I ordered it from there. So today I can show you demo. It's from Artholic, and she has different kind of strips and strip organizer and this battery operated slotted tool. So I'm going to demonstrate you today with that slotted tool. So I'm going to take half strip. So we need four double curve I shape. So this tool also has one slot. So insert strip inside the slot, and it has button. So just press this button and that's it. And you can remove it carefully and just put it in the circle sizer. So it's that easy. And now glue it. So we need four double curved I shape and two I shapes. So with this one, I'm going to show you both shapes. So remove the coil, loose coil. Now you can see this is blue part. What you can do, hold coil like this and pinch like this from both sides. So this is I shape. So you need two I shapes and four double curve I shapes. So this is I shape. Let's do double curve I shape with this I shape. So take this I shape and then hold like this and bring one hand down like this. So this is double curved I shape. So you need two I shapes and four double curved I shape. And then you also need six teardrops. So I'm going to use 1/4 strip. You can use half strip. If your strips are small, you can use half strip. Hi Preeti, how are you? So I am using 1/4 strips, and now I will show you with regular slotted tool. So this one has slot. Insert strip inside the slot, hold it like this and roll it. Roll it very gently. Don't press these fingers. And then remove it and keep it in small circle. As we need same size circles, we are going to use circle sizer. And then put glue on the edges, on the open end. So I already made some small coils. Then remove it and again find the glued part like this. Hold it like this and move the center opposite to glue part and pinch it. So this is teardrop. I think I will show you with big strip, because this was the small strip. You may not see carefully. So I will show you again with big strip. I am doing good, Preeti. How is your crocheting going on? So let it open like this. And now what you can do, so this is open part, right? Hold it like this. Move this center opposite to this open part and then pinch it like this and then put glue. Or first you can put the strip inside this circle sizer to make same size circles, then glue it and then pinch it. So this is teardrop. We need small teardrops. So you need 6 of these. I already made some of these. Yes, I need a couple of more. Now, if you are using strips like me that has some different different color edges, so you have to be careful while rolling it, so that all the you can see when all the shapes will be on one side. Now let's glue it. Take any board, our regular board. Okay, let me see. Let's adjust this camera. Now take double curved eye shape and put glue like this on this side and here. Put it here and take another. Okay, wait. First, let's put some pins. Use pins and put pins here. And now take another eye shape and glue it like this and put pins. So this will be not regular circle shape, so this will be a little bit different shape. So I wanted to try something different, so I came up with this design. Now another side, same, put glue here and on the bottom and put it here, put pins, another and glue another double curl eye shape. So let me show you how it will look. So it will look like this. So 2 on these sides, 2 on other side. If you want, you can make put 2 here and 2 here, and you can make square shape ornament. But I'm going to do something different. So let's see how does it look. So I'm going to use 2 eye shapes here. So let's put glue here and glue eye shape here and then use pins. Another eye shape here, opposite side, glue another eye shape. And use pins. Like this. So your ornament will look like this. Now let's use small teardrops. So I'm going to glue 2 teardrops here. I'm using only one color strips. If you want, you can use different color strips. Another one goes here like this. Now I'm going to glue 4 teardrops here on these corners. So this will be very small ornament, not big. Like this. And then use pins. Pins like this. And if you want, I want small ornaments, that's why I'm going to stop here only. But if you want, you can add more things around it. Let me remove some pins from the side and then I will show you how does it will look. But I am not going to remove middle pins because otherwise all small parts will fall apart. So you can see the ornament is small, so you can use any way, this way or like this way. If you want, you can use this as a magnet, or you can glue this on a gift or on the napkin ring. You can decorate napkin rings with this, or you can just make this and put it on the greeting card. You can use anywhere. And if you want to use as a magnet or on the napkin ring or ornament, don't forget to apply Mod Podge, or you can use spray adhesive, or you can use clear varnish, or if you don't have anything of this, you can use one part of regular glue and one part of water and mix it together and use any kind of brush and apply that mixture on one side first apply on the sides, then on one side. Let that dry for some time and then flip it and apply on the other side. If you do that, your ornament will be very sturdy and it will last long. And I forgot to tell you one thing. While removing these pins, be careful, don't remove like this, because sometimes what happens, the middle part comes out. So use your fingers like this and then remove all pins. So let me see if it dry. It's a little bit wet, but now you can see. So ornament look like this one. Tomorrow when it dries, I will take nice picture and I will put it on the page. Okay, just a minute. So I hope you like this ornament and I hope you will make something by watching my videos. If you make something by watching my videos, then don't forget to take a picture of that project, small project, and don't forget to share that picture with me. I would love to see those pictures. And if you want to make something else, something different, you can also let me know. I will try to show you those things. So that's it for today. Thank you for coming. And if you are watching this as a replay, don't forget to do comment and say replay so that I will know you are watching as a replay. So that's it for today. Bye. Happy quilling.